Today's clock is by Jülich, an East German company. It's an 8-day time-based clock. It's not a very wide clock, as you can see. Most German mantle clocks of this style were a lot wider than this. This is actually made in the same kind of proportions as a British clock of the period. I like the pressed decorations fixed to the case and the shiny numerals. This clock is in very good cosmetic condition. I did have to do some repair work on it though. It's only when you get to the back of the clock that it starts to look a bit unusual. Instead of a hinged door, we have this round lid which is held in place by a piece of spring. It just lifts off like that. And there we have the unusual triangular movement with a barbell shaped pendulum. And here is the movement. It's almost triangular in design. It's quite an unusual movement. Instead of a barrel for the mainspring, we have this metal disc which is held to the main wheel by four pillars. So although it is technically an open mainspring, it works in the same way as a barrel, with the ratchet fixed to the front plate, or to the frame I should say. And also, a peculiarity of East German movements, I find that they often have an extra wheel between the main wheel and the escape wheel. So there are more wheels generally in an East German movement than in a West German movement, and that is the escapement there. It's a pin pallet deadbeat escapement. Now I'll show you the pendulum. Just a barbell design, quite unusual also. The suspension spring has been replaced by a piece of plastic cut from a drinks bottle or something. I can actually see the word Ingredienten on there, which is a nice touch. Now when I got this clock, three of the pivots were out of alignment with the pivot holes on the back plate, and the back plate was slightly bent. So I had to unwind the mainspring, get the pivots reset back in the plates, and make sure the plates were straight. The plate was only bent because the pivots were out of it. How that happened, I don't know. But look how thin those plates are. But that's not really a problem because the movement is so narrow, the pillars are so short, that it partly alleviates the thin plates. It makes them slightly less susceptible to being bent. A very unusual movement. It's just had a dunking in the ultrasonic cleaner and a spot of oil, and it's ready to go back in the clock. And there it is working, hopefully. You see the Brocco escapement there. The brass of the plates is very, very thin and it bends quite easily. You have to be very careful with it. Well, the plastic suspension has come apart. Well, it seems to be going. I think I might be able to declare this one a success. And that's it in situ. That's where the Winterhalter and Hofmeyr quarter striking clock was. Okay, if you like this video, please click like and subscribe. My Facebook link is down below, and my PayPal link if you'd like to support this channel. And I'll see you in the next video.